Hi guys, Tracer here. Welcome back to Life is Strange. In the last episode, we found Chloe in a wheelchair and she was like challenged, physically challenged. But I'm trying something new out. You might hear a little bit of buzzing in the background. It's a fan because it's 89 degrees outside and it's 11:43 at night and somehow it's still that hot. So I'm fucking cooking up in this bitch. So sorry about that. I'm switching the mic audio around so you'll be able to hear me more over the game audio. So let me know what you think about it in the comments below. Either way, let's jump right back into the game. You must have fell asleep watching a movie.
Sleep so fast. How dare you?
I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep the swag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. You're the pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
I got you, Chloe. Nope, don't even look at her wheelchair. You're gonna hurt her feelings. Hello, William. Just gonna sneak upstairs. The fuck does Victoria want? I don't know. Bathroom. Is it the, I think it, yep, it's this one. What the fuck is Oh, really? Now I could probably see shit. Yep, look at that. No, don't look at yourself in the mirror.
Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering a morphine to my best friend.
I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be able to see the needle in this. There's just no way. Look how big it is. What? Wasn't this the garage? Am I just losing it? Here you go.
Finally. Give me the blue pill.
I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise.
Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless.
Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up.
Oh, trust me. I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high.
You're so adorable. Do you want anything else?
Stop me if I'm being too emo, but can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids.
Please. My diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever.
Let's see what we got. Hey, it's a snow dome.
Oh my god. I made that mix for her when we were 12.
Oh, we're not playing that. Let's find the photo album. That's it. We're not looking out the window.
Is that okay?
Perfect. Oh my god. Look how little we are there. We look like toys.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
There's still time for you. Oh man, there we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Literally seems like yesterday.
I wish it was.
Me too. This photo. Maybe I could.
No.
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So, I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory.
I can't.
You understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
I don't know if I can. Oh my god. Oh my god, but she's gonna suffer if I don't. And if I don't know, she's probably gonna get someone to do it for her because she can't do it herself. Oh my god. Fuck.
Chloe. I'll just drift asleep, dreaming of us here together, forever.
Thank you so much. I'm so proud of you for following your dreams. Don't forget about me.
Never.
I love you, Max. See you around.
Sooner than you think.
Get the photo and go back. us. Let's go
I'm
back
sorry,
in.
William.
We're getting in there. Got it.
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper. Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course, I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean the college fund? Aha! You can't hide from me forever. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, what did you see that?
She's never leaving.
That makes all of us.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like, you're never gonna see us again. Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always. I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together. Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Not anymore. I'm just spaced out too.
Welcome back to the real world.
Let's look at the big board and see all our pieces in the puzzle so far.
Whew. All right.
so close, yet so far away. We have to do three main things.
Right. What things?
One, decipher Frank's logbook. Two, get Nathan's phone to find out where he's been during the Vortex Club parties with Kate and Rachel. And see whatever hidden shit he's got in his messages.
Three, beat Stepdouche Dan until he tells us about Frank, Nathan, and the Darkroom. And I do have a gun.
Keep it in your pants. We'll have to do this on our own.
Dude, at least let me kick his ass, then rewind. Fine, whatevs. It's your power.
Which I can't waste on shit like that. Or Blackwell would be in big trouble.
You didn't even let me take that money to pay Frank off.
And I'm glad. We have to be better than that.
I know. You should get busy in the garage to see what dirt you can dig up. I'm gonna cyberstalk some names and see where that leads. And to who. And be careful of Stepcrack. He's not gonna be a happy camper after you reamed him yesterday and Mom is giving him the boot.
I'm on it, partner.
We're gonna start the search Sunday. And by then, all these episodes will be the day of. They'll be recorded right then and there. Good and late, like I always do it. But thank you guys for watching. I'll see you Sunday.